is broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
A blessed good morning and welcome to the Leeward Islands District Devotions. I am Bernice Gumbs, an accredited preacher in the St. Maarten Circuit. I'm pleased to bring you the devotion for today. Be blessed. Our theme for this week is our Methodist heritage, yesterday, today, and the future. The scripture text for the general theme is found in the epistle of Romans chapter 8, verse 14 to 17 and 31 to 39. Let us now worship God as we sing our theme song.
A church to keep my heart, a God to glorify, a never dying soul to save, and living for the sky, to serve the present age.
Praise God. Let us pray. Abba Father, in the name of Jesus, we express praise and gratitude to you for all you have done for us. Pour out your Spirit upon us afresh, that we will be empowered and reassured of our salvation. Holy Spirit, open the eyes of our soul so that we will receive your word and see the gifts you have put before us today. Thank you for the gift of life, for grace and mercies that are new to us each morning. Remember those who have not yet accepted your saving grace, Lord, and draw them by your Spirit. Touch and bless all who are worshiping with us today. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen.
Astra White, representing the St. Peter's Congregation. The scripture reading is taken from Romans chapter 8, verses 14 to 17, and continuing at verses 31 to 39. Here beginneth the 14th verse. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you do not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If, in fact, we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. Verse 31. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, Will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake, we are all being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Loving Father, anoint your word so that your people will open up their hearts to receive it, to the honor and glory of your name. Amen. Our meditation is entitled Assurance of Salvation. Theologically, we may say assurance of salvation is the inner knowledge that God has forgiven us in Christ and accepted us in his beloved Son, Ephesians 1:6. In our text for today, the Apostle Paul gives us four pieces of evidence of our salvation, namely, being led by the Spirit of adoption, the witness of the Spirit with our spirit, and the sufferings that we endure. Let us now take a closer look at the four evidences of our salvation. Being led by the Spirit emphasizes our walk with Christ. Here the Apostle Paul affirms our behavior should be a living example of God's word, demonstrating in the fruit of the Spirit in our lives. Galatians 5:22-23. For we were meant to live by the Spirit on a high level, where victory reign and righteousness. The Spirit is life. God wants us, brothers and sisters, to operate in the Spirit and not in the flesh. In the flesh, we will encounter many hindrances that will rob us from full assurance of our salvation, namely unbelief, fear, doubt, lukewarmness, the lack of forgiven spirit, disobedience to the word of God, walking by sight, by feelings instead of faith. Sin enslaves us, but thank God for his grace. For the same God who gracefully justifies us also preserves us in our weakness. For he loves us with an everlasting love. We experience his assurance of salvation forever because of peace and righteousness in the Lord Jesus Christ, whom God raised from the dead. Brothers and sisters, we also have the assurance of our salvation because we have been adopted as sons and daughters by the Father. We have received the Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of adoption. He enables us to cry out, Abba, Father. We can be assured of our salvation because Romans 8:16 declares, The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. As children of God, we have the rights, position, and privileges as heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ our Savior. Praise God. As children of God, we too will endure many sufferings, hardship, but are not to be compared with the glory about to be revealed to us by God. We can emulate the lives of Apostle Paul and John Wesley. Both remained faithful, steadfast, and unmovable in their faith during suffering. The Apostle Paul testified, "I know in whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day." 2 Timothy 1:12. This was Paul's confidence, his security in Christ. John Wesley, the founder of Methodism, in his Aldersgate experience testified, "I fell, I trust in Christ, Christ alone for salvation, and an assurance was given me that Jesus had taken away my sins, even mine, save me from the law of sin and death that I know not. But this I know, I have now peace with God." What an awesome assurance. What a confidence. What a testimony. What about yours this morning? I encourage you to throw off the hindrances in your life and hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering. For he who has promised is faithful. God is faithful. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your word that went forth. We thank you, God, for the assurance of your salvation through your Holy Spirit. Bless us, O Lord, and keep us. This I pray in Jesus' name. Our closing hymn is VIP 235. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Receive the benediction. May the God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless and keep us in Jesus' name. Amen. Do have a wonderful day. God bless you all.
The Lord lift his countenance upon